Howdy, tubers. Welcome back to my messy bench. The parts cannon was fired off. Actually, this is residual from the last couple of videos. This video is obviously released way later than the other ones. I don't know what the order is, but anyways, rear shocks are ready to go. I got my stud here. Yeah, that's for... been waiting on that. Got that, so that's for another time. I was gonna do that when I put the airbags in, but I didn't because I didn't have that part. So we're gonna go over what we're gonna do today. So this is a big thing. This is actually the reason why we're gonna be in here. We got lower control arm bushings. It looks like there's probably a bigger one that goes on. I don't know which side. We'll have to figure that out. A bigger one and then a smaller one. And then sort of a similar thing on the front, or the uppers, is that there's like a kind of a longer bushing and then a shorter bushing. I'm gonna make sure these fit. These are four Crown Victoria Mount Mercury Grand Marquis and Marauder. And we'll make sure those fit before we get too far, because I would hate to tear. Well, I guess I could do the ball joints and stuff, but you know, I want to do the everything at once and then do the steering alignment. It also comes with these. We're going to see if we can get these to fit in there. So that's that. This is the main reason why we're doing this, so hopefully that all works. And then we have the parts bag. Let's get all these out. We're going to go over these here just to show you what I got. Alright, so this guy here, what is this? Should be a lower ball joint. So I got a lower ball joint for this thing. Should be a second one here. So ball joint, I think it's this one. Yep. So we got two lower ball joints. This car's got 178,000 miles on it, almost 179. So I'm just gonna do all this. Let's see, what do we got here? This is the upper ball joint. Yeah. Ah, this is it. Here's the other one. This one's got a little different boot on it, which I thought was weird. But there's that. So we got two lower ball joints, two uppers. And then let's see, what's this guy here? I think this is the... Okay, good, got a boot there. I was like, why am I missing a boot? I think this is the tie rod end that goes into the steering knuckle. Kind of a dinky little thing. I think for this one, should be another inner tie rod end. Of course, the boot is in the bag. Should grab polyurethane boots. Just, you know, dress it up. And this should be the inner. The inner tie rod end. Yeah, this goes to the center link. So on my driver's side, this one's actually starting to blow out. We've got another one here. Just open these up just to check the quality of them, make see what they're like. Careful of the pokey bits. But yeah, there's another one. Got a grease circ, and we're gonna run Bigfoot grease through all of these, so these should last quite a while. So yeah, there's that. I got a couple things to do with the car, and I will get it situated, and we'll start on the driver's side. All right, so looking at this job here, I'm thinking how can we get to that control arm bolt back there? I'm almost thinking probably gonna have to pull this inner fender well. Oh, as you can tell, I put new brakes on this a while ago. Brand new pads, brand new rotors. Pads were glazed over. They look like, literally look like glass. So I put new and she stops pretty good. Okay, so I was just looking at this again while the compressor was pumping up. If you pull this, get this out of here and pull this back, you can actually, you can get to that bolt. So it's a little tight, but we can get to it. So not too bad. So what I would like to do is just kind of get things loosened up. I was thinking of actually knocking the tie rods off, getting this loose and popped out. Excuse me. So get this loose, pop the tie rod or the sway bar links out. We actually did a video like last summer and we ran into a snag where the kit that I bought wouldn't fit the sway bar. So I bought another set of links. Now they fit, and then we just reused the bushing from the other kit. I'm probably gonna replace those with some energy suspension bushings. I think that's kind of where this car is gonna go. So what I wanted to go over is why are we replacing these bushings? Well, look at that. And this one you can't see from this angle, but that one's pretty bad too. And then look at the lower ones. And because the suspension is so soft on this car, and for a while the shocks were pretty well blown out, but even with good shocks, this suspension moves a lot. It's very soft. You know, it absorbs a lot of inconsistencies in the road. And, you know, it rides pretty good. And as a result of it riding good, it has devulcanized the bushings. They're not on the pin anymore. It doesn't flex the rubber. It just moves around. So what actually happens is when you hit the brakes, this front, this upper control arm goes forward and this lower one actually will go back a little bit. See right now, because I hit the brakes on it, everything's far forward and then this is pushed all the way back. So yeah, that's why we're doing this. And it looks like when we put our bushings in, you have one head on this side, one head on that side, and that should keep it centered. But it looks like the head on that one's pretty well squashed. I want to get these loose, and I kind of want to get a picture of where they're at, because I want to get it close. So what I'm going to do is just start by getting these two loose, and it turns out 21 millimeter seems to fit. Oh, look at that. I didn't even... that was loose. Okay. So, I think what I'm going to do when I go to put the new ones on, I'm just going to get them, I guess, close. Because I'm putting... This is going to go on a steering alignment. Oh, these are loose. This is going to go in for a steering alignment, you know, for sure. Because we're redoing everything. Okay, so that's loose. We can deal with that off the car. Pretty good, that's for sure. I think I tightened that with a breaker bar. You guys wanna see if I'll waste this universal? Nice. Let's get this guy unplugged. I know there's a tool for this, and I have it, and it's hiding. There we go. Yeah, mostly destroyed it. That's okay, we'll hook her right here, she'll be fine. Okay, the actual pigtail for it is hiding back here. There's a little white doodad. That out. Get her past the airline. There. I need to get a new one of those, but don't worry about it, tubes. Let's get this tie rod knocked off of here. Our shock. Well, the bushing isn't totally trashed yet. Can you see what I'm working on? You're out of my way, so shouldn't have to kick you out. Come on, Al. There we go. We got a little bit of fuckery involved here. So, had to do a little bit of work here. That's still pretty hot. So these are supposed to have the washers on the outside. I may have to... Oh, look at that. That doesn't even fit in there. That one fits. So maybe this one fits over here. But check out, this is the bushing that came out. I didn't have to do anything to get this out. I just wiggled it out, just like I did with the polyurethane bushing. Normally these would be vulcanizing it, and this is just completely wore down, but check that out. Isn't that awesome? get her crispy crittered. There we go. And then I just need my grabbing antler here. Oh, it's getting ready to come off. I just gotta hammer at it some more. Gotta have those washers in there because they help everything bite. Look at that bushing. Let's see how easy this one come out. The other one practically just slid right out. This one might have a little resistance. We were starting to wear into the shells. I'm glad I'm doing this now. Oh, look at that. We were wearing thin. Well, does this other bushing fit in here? Kinda loose. Well, I'm pretty annoyed that this isn't gonna work. So, I may return this. But then, the other problem is these shells are actually damaged on the ends here. They're razor sharp, so I think I'm gonna run over to probably Napa and actually get new bushings. Well, anyways, let's get this off and put a new ball joint on. So I gotta buy rubber freaking bushings for this. I can move that in or out, and this moves it side to side. TRW, well, this was fairly new, so somebody's been up there. That one feels okay, but hey, got new. I'm really pissed about the ball joint, or that. Bob Saget. So here's our new fancy schmancy bolt and our alignment. Something like that. That. So now I gotta figure out this bushing situation. Well, should we try and knock these out? Maybe throw some heat around this part here and just patink, patink, patink. Alright, well, I'm gonna go run to Napa and pick up those bushings. Disappointed I have to use rubber, but I guess guess that's what we're gonna have to do. So, as you can see, I just deformed the ends of these things. First I heated it up with the torch, at least for the thicker end, got it bent over. But it seems if you just
deform that end there, you can actually just hammer it out, and it comes out pretty easy. And I probably would recommend doing this on a, look at that. Probably be better if I need an anvil. That's going to be something I'm going to get as an anvil, because I probably would have that done pretty quick. Well, we got one control arm ready to go. I went over to Napa to order bushings, and they can't get them until like Saturday. So those are on order, and that cost me more than this polyurethane kit. So I'm probably gonna see about returning that to Amazon, because that's bullshit. Tubes, I beat, and I finally got that lower ball joint separate from the knuckle. Lots of heat, lots of vibration. Son of a bitch. All right, beating and hammering, heating. Finally got that free. So here's the lower bushings. Now check this out. This has got... Let's see, where's that kit? I think we can get away with the lowers. So it looks like that will fit there. Yeah, I think that's gonna fit there. And then you got this one. Yeah, so we can do polyurethane on the lower and rubber on the upper. So I'm gonna cancel the order for the lower control arm bushings. That's gonna work. So what I need to do is get my C-clamp or something to push these metal pins out, and then we can get the rubber out. So that's going to work. Sweet. Well, you guys missed a pretty good fight. We're about to do it again. I got the bushing out on this side. You just heat it until it catches fire, and then it comes right out. It's the next day. I fought quite a bit with this. Oh, I haven't even got to the ball joint yet. Got a new one right here. So let me
So in the last video, a little crappy because I was actually fighting this a lot, and I turned the camera off several times because it's a lot of editing that I'd have to do, and I wanted to cut it down. So maybe the other side will do a little more better with the video. This side, I fought and fought to get these bushings out, and I ended up having to take what you guys saw, the torch, heat up the bushing, and it basically just starts to melt it and turn it into a goo, and it not necessarily falls out, but you can get it out. And then driving these suckers out. Woof. I put my impact gun to the max. I hope the compressor still works. So anyways, my polyurethane kit that I bought for this car. This is listed for the Crown Victoria 92 to 97. Now those technically should have the same control arms, but there are some differences between the control arms, and I will show you that here in a second. Now I went into the upper, which we kind of did a video on that. And that's when we found out the upper bushings didn't work, so I knocked the shells out. I went and ordered new bushings, and I'm going to get to that here in a second. So the uppers on this kit have two different size bushings. This kind of fits, but then it's loose on one, and really those shells are trash because you saw how much movement there was this way, and everything was just a mess. And then you've got these weird washer things. You know, you gotta knock those out, and it's not working out. So I went to Napa and ordered, hang on, you guys are cut off. So anyways, I went to Napa and ordered upper and lower bushings because I thought this kit wasn't gonna work. And so, order the kit, I get back home, and I get this lower control arm out, and I'm looking at it. One bushing looks bigger than the other. I was like, wait a minute. I bet you on this lower control arm it uses a different size bushings on each end. And it does. So I spent a few hours with the help of the neighbor supplying me with alcohol. I got the bushings out and stuff, and just, oh, what a nightmare. Anyways, cleaned it out, and I was able to get these pressed in and drove the pins in and everything. And I was just like, oh, that one's not in all the way. Yeah. I was freaking out because the pins on these are different lengths. They're slightly different. So I was like, oh my God. Yeah, it looks like the shorter one goes through this one. Okay. Anyways, so I ordered these bushings. I got the uppers. Man, you know what? If I were to do this over again, I would just say, screw the whole poly kit. Don't buy the ball joints, just buy all the control arms. And, you know, time-wise, it's more effective to just buy the control arms. Might cost more, but I've still spent a lot of money on this. Spent $80 on this kit, and I can only use half of it, or three-quarters of it. And then now I'm spending another $100 for upper control arm bushings. Imagine that. I ordered the lowers, and at the time I thought, oh yeah, you know, they're the same size bushings, so they ordered the same size, all four. That was $111 just for the lower control arm bushings. So then I get home, realize these are same size bushings, or different size bushings, excuse me. And so what I ordered is not going to work. And then I looked at my receipt, and they only ordered two of the upper control arm bushings, so I went back this morning, canceled the order on the lowers because I now know that these work and we're going to use these. I think this is a more important part anyways for the suspension because it's where your coil spring rides, and that's a lot of where the load is distributed. So this will panel pretty good with this, and then we'll have rubber up top and it'll be fine. But anyways, I changed my order, got two new and everything all said and done. Still about $100, but I got $50 back. So
So yeah, the pin still has a little ways to go. So I believe this was the smaller bushing. It uses the shorter pin. And then this is the bigger bushing. It uses the longer pin, and that fits pretty good. This one, what I'm worried about is that, you know, we're going to have to lubricate this pretty heavily because that pin there, you know, needs to bite onto the control arm. Maybe this mushroom's back out. I'm just worried about there being a lot of friction there and eating this up, and then we end up with the same problem that we had. This, I believe it was this bushing right here. This one was actually like squished all the way up here and was actually getting ready to wear into the shell. So I caught this right in just in time. This car's got 178,000 miles on it. And let's see. This was one of the upper control arm bushings. You can see it was pretty well trashed and it was wearing this outside. There's supposed to be another piece right here, but you can see it wore it off. So yeah, not good. I slept in till about probably 10:30 today. I went to bed at 8 something last night. Slept in till, you know, 10 or so. Kind of woke up and then I realized, you know, I need to go over to Napa and take care of my order because something ain't right. So what I'm going to do is, I think I'm going to heat up this area to release, to shock this. And then what I'm going to do is get some of the stuff off the workbench here, and I think I'm going to try and hammer it out with the sledge. Well, it's certainly moving, but it's not going straight. Take this cup, put it like that, and then she's coming out. Gotcha, bitch. I don't think we wallered it out too bad. We can always weld it in, right? New ball joint. What I like about the ball joints and everything I got, it's got grease circs. So now on this, we can put, what did I think? It was this, it was gonna be this cap. Put that up against the ball joint, and then it was gonna be what this guy should be. This guy, the key is to get this nice and straight. So like in this case, we're not gonna go in straight at all.
Oh yeah, we're in there. Nice. Alright. Give it a couple of whacks here, just to make sure we're in there, but I think we're in there.
I'll tell you what, I feel a lot better about this today than I did yesterday. Yesterday I was about ready to throw up. So this is done. Got our new bushings in there. Now getting it in is going to be fine because we also had to put the spring in there, and we're also going to attempt using this. I would like to use this, like I said, to add a little more tension to the springs. But this is done. Let's see. I think this is a spot for the grease to come out. Normally, you would want to orientate this like out this way, but I'm going to send this one. We'll be fine. So new ball joint, new bushings. The only thing I'm not doing is putting a bump stop in. This car should have air bumps. In the next video, we are going to tackle we still have to do the upper control arm bushings, so we'll throw those in. And then once we throw those in, then we can put together the driver's side and move on to, then we got steering links to do. We got a lot to do in the next video, and then we're just on the driver's side. All right, tubes. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you next time.